question for all of you. Kerala is very different from all other states in the sense that until about 3 years ago, research and data showed us that almost 40% of a year's sale happened during 30 days. Now that's putting too much pressure on people in sales, entrepreneurs like the two of them, to perform in that 1 month or perish. Isn't it good that we spread it out over at least 3-4 months? Or we have another season? Have you ever thought of developing another purchase season like Onam? Akshaya Tritiya, of course, has happened in a small way, but that's not major compared to Onam that fades away. Is it a good idea to think of a concept like that?
Actually, it is a time has come, because maybe today is a best day, because we have trade partners, media partners, event management, it's a full team. Actually, Kerala is the only state, this completely year turnover is depending on one season called Onam. It is not the question anywhere else in the country or any state. If you take the next neighboring state, Tamil Nadu, if you take it, Tamil Nadu, January 1st, New Year sale is really good. Then immediately after 15 days, the Pongal sale will start.
Yeah, the Makar Sankranti.
And if you go to April, like Vishu, Tamil Nadu is having Tamil New Year, Chitra Tirunal. Moving to July, July is not an auspicious month. Actually, good things will not happen in July. But Tamil Nadu has converted that season also into Adi season. The July is over, then Diwali has come, and Christmas has come. So if you ask me whether it is an auspicious season or not, traditionally, Tamil Nadu or any state you take it, there are more than 4 to 5 seasons. In Kerala is the only state in the country, the yearly revenue or the total business is completely dependent on one particular season, these 3 months. So our own hard work, investment, effort, all aspect if you take it, the time has come. Seriously, Kerala trade partners, manufacturers, I am not talking about only trade partners, including people like us, manufacturers, trade partners, media, group, everybody has to seriously think and create another 2 more seasons. Otherwise, it is going to be a hectic way forward. It will be really tough.
And I would second that thought of what Sudhir is mentioning. It is actually putting too much of pressure on resources, as you rightly said, on sales or on media. And it is not a good, healthy practice also. Because what happens last year, for example, as you have seen, it was washed away because of the floods, etc. So everybody was crying and people were stuck with hundreds of thousands of millions of stocks. Mm. People have spent all over. See what happens when Onam comes, then you start diverting all resources to one place. And it is a matter of those 30, 45 days. You are in or you are out.
Okay.
And you don't have a second chance. And as Sudhir was also mentioning that you have festival after festival, and even if festivals are not there, I'm saying, for example, summers are there. So we have seen a lovely summer season this year for air conditioners, and April, May, June, where the growth was very good. And I'm hoping that because of that good season of summer, Onam will also be good. So we should have summer, we should have those, then we should have something else. And either we need to create it by the mindset or by the product launches during the some different season, so that we can, you know, stagger the sales throughout the year, and everybody is beneficial out of it. Because the moment you come out of Onam and then you went to anything you want to promote, sir, I think it will be a good idea that we should do it next time when it is Onam. So okay. Onam and Onam and Onam. Hmm. So we must come out of this.
Okay, so the takeaway is that Kerala must have at least 2 different celebrations, one in August, one somewhere else. We need to think about it and develop one.
We retail groups always, including our association and everybody, we all always wanted to have a second or third season as we, everybody wants. But we feel that the manufacturers should take the initiative.
I see. Okay.
Along with the media.
What do you think, Syed? Because if you also say this, then the unanimity that, you know, we should not be celebrating only 1 month a year. We should be more like the rest of the country, where, you know, at least 6 months.
Like us, we are the scapegoats. In okay. fact, we are more troubled than the manufacturers, I would say.
Sai, that's like your opinion.
We take so much pressure.
Yeah, Onam, that that Onathinte oru 15-20 days aanu major sales varunathu. Sales-inte 30% pandu Onam nu parneyirunnal കർക്കിടം കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു മാസമായിരുന്നു ഇത് വന്നിരുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ ആൾക്കാർ കർക്കിടത്തിൽ പർച്ചേസിങ് പവർ ആരും വാങ്ങില്ല, എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് ചെയ്യും.
ഓക്കെ,
ആ ഒരു ഇന്നിപ്പോൾ കർക്കിടത്തിലും ആ മാസം സെയിലുണ്ട്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് അഡീഷണൽ ഇപ്പോൾ ആൾക്കാർ ഓഫേഴ്സ് ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ ഓഫേഴ്സും കാര്യങ്ങളും വെയിറ്റ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന ടൈമാണ്.
ഓക്കെ,
ഇവൻ ഫിനാൻസ് പാർട്ട് ഫിനാൻസ് കമ്പനിയും ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ ടൈമോട് കൂടെ ആയിരിക്കും. ഇപ്പം കേരളത്തിൽ ഒരു ഞങ്ങളുടെ മൊബൈൽ സെഗ്മെൻറ്റിൽ 30% ഫിനാൻസ് സെയിലാണ്, ഫിനാൻസ് ക്രെഡിറ്റ് കാർഡ്. അത് ഈ ഓണത്തോട് കൂടിയിട്ട് ഒരു അപ് ടു 50%ലോട്ട് പോകും. പണ്ട് ആൾക്കാർ ക്യാഷ് കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് വന്നിട്ടായിരുന്നു ഫോം വാങ്ങിച്ചിരുന്നത്, അത് മാറി. അത് ആ 50% വരും. അതിൻ്റെ കൂടെ തന്നെ ഈ ഒരു 7,000 രൂപയൊക്കെ ആയിരുന്നു ഞങ്ങളൊരു ആവറേജ് സെയിൽസ് വന്നിരുന്നത്. ഒരു അതിപ്പോൾ 10,000 വന്നു. ഫിനാൻസ് വരാൻ ഡെഫിനറ്റ്ലി 15,000 പോകും. അപ്പോൾ ആ ഒരു 10-15 days ആണ് ഓണത്തിൻ്റെ മെയിൻ സെയിൽ വരുന്നത്.
ഓക്കെ, ലെറ്റ് മീ ആസ്ക് സുനിൽ നമ്പ്യാർ ഓൾസോ, വാട്ട് യു തിങ്ക് ആസ് എ മീഡിയ പേഴ്സൺ, ഡു യു വോണ്ട് ഗെറ്റ് ഓൾ യുവർ അഡ്വർടൈസിംഗ് ഡ്യൂറിംഗ് വൺ മന്ത് ഓർ വുഡ് യു ലൈക്ക് ടു ഹാവ് ഇറ്റ് സ്പ്രെഡ്?
I mean, definitely it's not just a spread. I would like to get more advertisement than Onam during the other part of the months.
Okay.
Now, as what Mr. Peter has said very rightly,
yeah.
Now, it is the onus is with the media and the onus is with the manufacturer to ensure that we create a market, because only if we could create the market, that market could be carried forward by the retailers and distributors like Mr. Peter and the other gentlemen here.
Yeah. Okay. I have a very different question to ask all of you about how the millennials are behaving in their consumption patterns. When I say millennials, I mean people who are 20-ish, who were born in the late 1990s onwards, who are about 20 now. They've got money. They are footloose and fancy-free. My question is, are they buying things like their senior generation did, or are they, as we hear, part of the gig economy where you share? You don't buy a car, you have a car sharing, you have an Uber. They don't buy a flat, they share. Is that happening, or do they continue to be like the previous?
Yeah, so I think millennials are completely different. That's, I mean, for sure. All habits in terms of buying, etc., whether yeah. they are buying as the older generation, etc., it is not there at all.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, they are more hooked towards the online sales, etc., that we have seen digital formulation, digitalization, as Bijur has also mentioned, that more and more it is happening towards digitalization. Third is that a lot of times people say that business is not there, and the business models are changing, and these millennials are changing the business models. All they're changing is that, for example, I'll give you my own personal example. So my son doesn't want to buy a car. He says Uber is better. For example, people are saying that restaurants are too many and people are not there. People are eating rather 10 times more what they were eating 5 years back. But Swiggy's and Zomato's are growing by 100 folds or 200 folds. And maybe restaurants are not growing as fast as they were. So,
and some of them are setting up their own kitchens in Bombay.
Sorry?
Huge kitchens. Some of the food delivery
yes.
apps so now, are setting up their own restaurants.
So now, as a matter of fact, I don't know about this place, but Domino's operates 3 a.m. in the morning in Bombay. And so many kitchens which only operate in the night.
Mm-hmm.
So many facilities which are open only after 10 p.m. in the night. So this is who is changing. Not the older generation, but the millennials is changing the habit. And millennials are forcing the businessmen to think and rethink about the business models which they want to operate in.
So do you want to add something about the millennials? All of you, actually.
I think that category is the highly influenced category through this digital media. And they are the crowd is moving toward this online. But this consumer durable industry, still this online has not crossed 5% of the business, except the mobile phone I'm talking. And I don't think so it is going to cross more than 10 to 12% in the next 4-5 years also. But yes, their decision making are fast, and they mainly go as per the digital platform and decide the product.
Okay.
What we have noticed is the youngsters, especially the millennial groups, what you said, they go for online mostly, but not for the consumer durable category such as. Because consumer durable category like air conditioner or refrigerator, they still depend on their parents or maybe the elders to make the final decision. They may go through the Google and find out the details and explain them the reviews and all sort of things, but The decision making is still with the parents in these categories.
Which means advertisers also should be targeting the parents.
Targeting, yeah.
The influencers and all should be targeting
exactly,
the parents.
Yes, that's what exactly.
Okay.
In our category, yes.
One more thing to add in this, what Sudhir has said about the percentage of offline and online.
Okay.
Even in the developed economies, it is not more than 7 to 8%.
Mm-hmm.
So that percentage will still remain hover around 7 to 8%. The width is increasing.
I see.
So so offline to online would be still 7 to 8% in developed economies also. So and especially for large consumer durables, still it is at 5-6%. Maybe mobile might be much higher, but for large consumer durable appliances, it is still 7 to 8%. So that percentage is not changing. Only thing is this: the millennials are influencing the buying patterns, whether it is being aesthetics or the technology, embracing of technology is getting becoming much faster. And decision making is also getting influenced by those millennials rather than divide between the channels of online and offline.
Okay. Said, what about young customers?
After the monetization, 92 ലാണ് ഇന്ത്യ ഒരു ഗ്ലോബൽ മാർക്കറ്റിലോട്ട് വരുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ ഓരോ ടൈമിംഗ് 92 to 95 എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഒരു സിമെൻറ്റ് ഇൻഡസ്ട്രി ബൂം ചെയ്തിരുന്നതാണ്. അപ്പോൾ അതുപോലെ അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ദാറ്റ് ഐ ടി കമ്പനി ഇൻഫോസിസ് അതുപോലത്തെ ഒരു കമ്പനി ചെയ്തു. നമ്മളെ ഈ ബാംഗ്ലൂർ പോലത്തെ സിറ്റി പോലും വന്നിരുന്നത് ആ ഒരു ടൈമിലാണ്. ആഫ്റ്റർ ദാറ്റ് 2002 പിന്നെ റിയൽ എസ്റ്റേറ്റ് കമ്പനി വന്നു. ഗുർഗാവ് ഡൽഹി ഒരു ഗുർഗാവ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സിറ്റി നമ്മൾ പറയുന്നത് റിയൽ എസ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഡി എൽ എഫ് പോലത്തെ ഒരു കമ്പനികൾ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം മൊബൈൽ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രിയിൽ മൊബൈൽ കരിയേഴ്സ് വന്നു. മൊബൈൽ റഷ്യ പോലത്തെ പല കമ്പനികളിൽ നിന്ന് ആൾക്കാർ എം ടി എസ് പോലത്തെ ഇന്ത്യയിൽ വന്ന് ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തു. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ദാറ്റ് 2010 പല മൊബൈൽ കമ്പനിയും ഇവിടെ ഇന്ത്യയിൽ ബോൺ ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത് 2010 ഇവൻ ഓപ്പോ വിവോ ഇവൻ പല കമ്പനികൾ വന്നിട്ട് അതിൻ്റെ ശേഷം ഇപ്പോൾ ലാസ്റ്റ് 2015 to 2020 വരെ മേ ബി ഇത് ആപ്പ് റിലേറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള കമ്പനി. ഇന്നിപ്പം ഈ ഓയോ ട്രിബോ അതിൻ്റെ 70% സെയിൽസ് വരുന്നത് മൊബൈൽ ആപ്പ് ത്രൂ ബിസിനസ്സാണ് വന്നിരുന്നുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇനിയിപ്പോൾ ഈവൻ ദ ബൈജു ഇപ്പോൾ പിള്ളേർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസിന് പോലും പാരൻസ് ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത് ടാബ് ഫോൺ അതിലോട്ട് ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു കാര്യമാണ്. അപ്പോൾ ഫ്യൂച്ചർ ഐ തിങ്ക് ഇസ് ബെറ്റർ.
താങ്ക് യു. സിൻസ് വി പ്രസ് ഫോർ ടൈം, ഐ എം ജസ്റ്റ് ആസ്കിംഗ് ദം വൺ ലൈൻ. ആർ യു ബുളിഷ്, ബെറിഷ്, സോ അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് ഓണം? From what you say, the audience can get a feel of how Onam is likely to be in Kerala.
We are very bullish about Onam.
Godrej is very bullish.
And
okay. So,
now, if the Jan to June, everybody is very happy in our industry.
Pardon me?
Jan to June, the okay, first Jan half of the year,
okay.
It was very good. That's what everybody will accept it.
Very good.
So yeah. Definitely H2 also will be much better than H1.
Okay.
As rightly said, first half was good. We all wish second half is also good, but as we rightly said, we don't want the season to be that peak that off season is going to be bad.
Okay.
So we want the Onam to be good. At the same time, post Onam is also to be good.
Sahid?
Last year Onam flood karana poyirunna, appa after this Onam is the great Onam, definitely.
Okay.
There is no doubt at all.
Okay. Compared to last Onam, this is certainly going to be
100%. There is no doubt.
Okay. And for you?
Yeah.
For the media?
For consumer durables, this, as Sudhir was suggesting, the first 3 months for us was extremely good. Air condition, advertisement business has gone up by almost 43%. And we definitely foresee this happening in the next quarter also. The advantage which we have now evolved in this discussion is that in case we are able to generate a next season, which is after Onam, I think it will look absolutely bullish.
So the general mood is bullish. From media to national brands to retailers who actually sell those products.